Today I'm gonna show you how we can find and defeat Godrick boss in Elden Ring. So we're gonna play Elden Ring. You want to follow my path, the one that I just showed you on the map. So if you miss that, you can rewind, you can slow it down. Everything is a little bit fast forward because I don't want to waste your time. Basically, you have to enter to the Stormveil Castle, and if you are a beginner, this will be your first boss in the game that you should fight. I know the game can lead you to another bosses, boss fights, but definitely this one is in all the main bosses in the game, this one is the easiest one to defeat. And also, I'm a very high level when I record this video because this game is so twisted. You can fight with the latest boss, with the ultimate boss in the game, and you can still come back here and you'll be very, very overpowered for this one, for this boss. Now, this will be the main gate. There is a way to enter to this main gate. I'm gonna show you the step that you have to take. You'll be right over here. Here you want to encounter the Margit. It will be a mini boss, or you can call him a boss, a main boss. Right over here you're gonna have a fight. You cannot pass this area without fighting that Margit. Now after you want to defeat that guy, I'm gonna show exactly the path that you have to take if you are crazy to fight that guy, but you can explore this castle a lot. Now at the entrance of the castle, which will be a closed gate, you can go here on the left end. If you talk with this guy three times, so be careful, talk with this guy three times. Now my dialogue with this one, it's another one, but first time you're gonna meet him, you can talk with him three times. It's gonna, after the third time, he's gonna ask you if you want to open the main door or if you want to leave it closed. So you can choose to open the main door, this the main gate. I just opened that main gate, and from now on you just have to run. If you don't want, you don't have to fight those guys, you just outrun them. They will not chase you. They will chase you, but they will not catch you. And I am pretty sure you are pretty tough, so you can resist some hits. Yes, you'll have those bows that coming straight at you, but again, if you are go fast enough, you can dodge every single arrow, every single sword. And here you're gonna have a big boss, pretty big boss that is pretty fast, so you'll want to outrun that guy. And you want to go here on the right. You'll see the birds, and if you are seeing the birds, you are on the right path. Just move on. And here you're gonna see a tree. Take that golden seed really fast. And here you're gonna see this big guy just watching you. It's gonna attack you, but you will not stay long enough for that. So you'll want to take this grace. This is the most important grace that you have to take here on the right side before you fight that ultimate boss from this castle. After this grace, let the fight begin. And let me tell you something else. If you want to explore all the castle and if you want to see all the secrets, I already have a video on my channel of how you can do that, so better watch that video if you like. I'm gonna leave you with this beautiful cutscene because this is something else, so watch it.
Mighty dragon, thou'rt a true born heir. Lend me thy strength, O kindred. Deliver me unto greater heights. Well. The lowly tarnished. Plain as a lord. I command thee.
Now let me tell you, maybe the fight for you is gonna be a little bit different because you don't have already the mimic tier, but I'm pretty sure you already have a summon. You should definitely come here with a summon early in the game, if you are early in the game. I don't even know which one is the best, but definitely you can upgrade your summon and you can defeat this guy pretty easy. Now for me it's just a piece of cake, I don't want to brag because yeah, I'm a high level, that is the game. When you are a high level you can beat anyone. As you can see I don't even want to fight that guy, but I'm gonna give you some advices. If you'll have a mimic, a spirit summon, you want to stay a little bit further and you want to take a ranged weapon. You can take a bow if you are on strength, you can take if you are a wizard, you can take some magic spells, and definitely you can reach this phase 2. Yes, this will be the phase 2, and at the phase 2 it will have a magical and a powerful weapon. And again, my advice for you is to stay a little bit further away, not that close, and try to arrange weapon. Also, you're gonna see it has a cycle with that magical weapon. When that cycle will stop, you can approach this guy and you can try to fight this guy with a sword. But let me tell you something, your grace is just outside of the gate, so if you die sometimes it's not a problem. Trust me, you're gonna defeat him. Bro, look how epic it looks. I absolutely love the cutscene from this video. You can stay out to hide a little bit between those graves, but go further. As I told you, that fire is pretty strong. And I just hit him with my sword of night and flame. You can take this sword very early in the game, the sword that we use late in the game. This is a sword that has been nerfed, but it's also very good right now. So you can take this sword pretty early in the game without fighting anyone. So I have a video on my channel of how you can get this sword, so definitely you should watch it. I just beat him. He's gonna say some other a little bit of a dialogue. And after you're gonna rest at that grace, because yes, a new grace will appear and that door will be open right now. You'll get a Godrick great rune and the remembrance. With that remembrance you can take two awesome sword at your table of the lost grace, of the round table on the map in the left side. If you don't know how to reach that, I will speak to you like you are a pretty new in this game. Because yes, I told you, this boss is something that you'll want to beat pretty early in the game. You'll get a decent amount of runes, so you can level up. But when you are high level, I mean 130, I don't even know what level I am right now. But those runes are not important at that level. Now, after you're gonna rest at this grace, the guy from the beginning of the gate, this one, is gonna smash Godrick's head. And you'll have another dialogue with this guy. You cannot buy things from him anymore right now. But I told you, the new door is unlocked and you can explore even further. And I'm gonna leave you with that. I'm gonna leave you explore. I'm gonna show you what it's inside. Maybe you are curious, but yeah, I just wanted to see all the dialogue. The main purpose of this video is to find him, because it's a very important to find this boss at the beginning of the game. It's important to take them step by step, not like me. I leave it behind because I have to admit I totally forgot about this guy. I did the Rani's quest, which is the most important quest for me in the game, side quest maybe, or no, it's a main quest, that one. I did that one and that led me to the end of the game almost. I can do whatever turn I. And now you can enter into that building and to explore even further. On the right side I think is nothing. Please tell me in the comments if you found something, because no, I didn't. But on the left side you can explore even further. You can go down on a ladder and you can explore. That's it. Thank you. Have a great day. If you enjoy my content, you can hit that like button. It's free. Like, subscribe, share, and definitely press the notification bell. That's the most important thing, because my next video may be something really good for you. I don't know. Be safe and see you soon. Bye.